Hello everyone, and welcome to West Pictures, game number 2 of the book How to Play the English Opening. Now, this day we are gonna see the game between Kasparov and SADVAKASOV in 2001, and Astana. 14 years after the match in Seville, Kasparov again faced the knight move e3 variation with white. His opponent at the Super Tournament in Ostrava was Darmen SADVAKASOV, the rising star of Casanchez. So the match started with c4, e5, knight to c3, knight to f6, knight to f3, knight to c6, g3, bishop to d4, the same as the last game, if you remember, and if you haven't seen the game, so go and watch it. Bishop to g2, short castle, e4, knight to g5, all the same, rook to e8, f3, and now e3. Remember that in the last game, Kasparov played d3, but he lost, so maybe now he decided to change the variation and played the move d takes e3. Queen to e7, an interesting maneuver, allowing the black queen to be effectively included in the struggle via the c5 square. Such an idea has already been seen before, but implemented only a couple moves later. Instead, they played b6, and after e4, h6, a delay in driving away the white knight might prove dangerous. What happened after bishop to a6 directly? Then f4, h6, and now we can take the pawn on f7, sacrificing the knight, because after king takes, we can play e5, king to g8, bishop to d5, check, king to f8, bishop to a3, knight g to e7, and queen to d3. As we saw in the last game, after d6 we can play queen to h7 and we are winning because we are treating checkmate on h8. So you have to kick out that knight first instead of playing directly the move bishop to a6. So h6 first of all, knight to h3. Now the positional sacrifice of the knight on f7 is not quite so effective, because after knight takes f7, king takes, if we play f5, king to g8, e5, knight to h7, bishop to a3, bishop to b7, bishop to e4, king to h8, bishop to c2, now we can take the pawn on e5, and after f takes e5 and rook takes e5, we have returned the sacrifice of the piece, but leave white back to the drawing board. This was played between Topalov and Genfal in 1997. So let's go back after the move knight to h3. The black pieces can reply queen to e7, knight to f4, queen to c5, check, king to h1, queen takes c4, knight to d5, knight takes, e takes, queen to a5, e4, c6, d6, and after bishop to b7, we can play g4. Even though we are losing the c3 pawn, queen takes c3, we can play bishop to d2, queen to f6, bishop takes the knight, b takes the bishop, and queen to d3. In this position, a draw was agreed, so white's chance appeared to be preferable. A game between Saskis and Abruchik in 1996. Black can attack the weak c4 pawn, also with minor pieces. Let's have a look at the game by Boris Kulko, one of the specialists in playing the white side of this variation. So let's go back to the move number 10 and let's see what happened after h6. Knight to h3, knight to e5. The black bishop can also join in the hunt of the c4 pawn with the move b6. And after e4, bishop to a6, attacking the c4 pawn, c5, and now b takes c5. What happens after, instead of playing c5, we try to defend the pawn with queen to a4. Then we have the move knight to a5, attacking twice the pawn of c4, and now you have to play c5. And after bishop takes e2, we are attacking the rook. The rook has to go to e1, and now the bishop just go back to e6. f4, for instance, bishop to b7, and now after knight to f2, this is a little advantage for black pieces. That wasn't played in the game. Instead of queen to a4, the white pieces play c5, and b takes c5. Bishop to a3, attacking the pawn, d6, protecting the pawn, queen to a4, attacking both the knight and the bishop, and now knight to b8. Knight to b8 is an interesting move, and actually is the best move, because if we play the logical bishop to b7, then we have rook a to b1. You have to protect the bishop with the queen, and now we can sacrifice the exchange, because now we can play f4, and we can see that the idea is to play e5, and we are using our strong bishop all along the diagonal. So for example, after f4, knight to d7, e5, knight d to b8, to b8, protecting the knight twice. We can play just bishop to e4 with the decisive trick of rook to b1. Let's go back to the move played by the black pieces. Instead of bishop to b7, knight to b8, and now what did the white pieces reply? Now white replied e5, sacrificing a pawn. As in the previous variation, we can see that our main idea is to open up the diagonal for our bishop. So e5, d takes e5, and now rook f to d1. Winning a tempo on the queen, the queen has to go to c8, and now we can play e4. After knight b to d7, we can play this move, because now our bishop is protected by the queen. So knight b to d7, what happens after bishop to e2, for example? We can just play rook to d2, and after bishop takes, and queen takes, actually we can play rook a to d1, and this is advantage for the white pieces. Instead of bishop to e2, knight b to d7, and now bishop and knight to f2 with a complicated game. Let's take a look at another match between Timoshenko and Nova Gorica, 1997. In this move, after the move knight to e5, the white pieces played e4, and now after knight takes e4, queen to d4, knight to e5, c4, d6, knight to f5, b6. b6 is one of the main variations. Now we can just play knight to d5, and after c5, queen to c3, knight takes d5, and now c takes d5, and b5. Worth considering is the solid f6. But well, they play a b5, and now after f4, kicking out the knight, instead of putting the knight away, we can play b4 first of all, winning a tempo on the queen, and queen to c2, and now we put the knight on d7. e5 finally opening the diagonal for the bishop, and after d takes e5, if takes e5, knight takes e5, we can play d6 opening the diagonal, and this pawn is quite strong. After d6, what can you play? You can play, for instance, bishop to a6, but what happens after rook to b8, for example, just putting the knight away? We can just play this move, queen takes c5, and we are protecting the d6 pawn. So after bishop to a6, bishop takes, now queen takes, and bishop to b2, queen to c6, attacking the d6 pawn, bishop takes, rook takes, and now rook a to d1, protecting the pawn. Bishop to c8, queen to d3, bishop to d7, we are blocking the pawn without bishop. As we know, the bishop is not a good blocker, better is a knight, but anyways, queen to f3, queen takes, e takes f3, king to f8, f4, rook to e2, rook f to e1, and white gains the upper hand in the endgame. Let's see what that stuff is say. More than 1.5 points of advantage. Now 2 points of advantage for white pieces. This is completely winning. The continuation d takes e3 has also been seen in Kasparov practice before. Though this was in a simultaneous exhibition. Nevertheless, let's take a look at this instructive game, in which one of White's basic ideas stand out: the activation of pawns on the king side. So d6, e4, h6, knight to h3, bishop to e6, g4, queen to d7, c5, d takes c5, queen to e1, knight to e5, queen to g3, bishop to c4, rook to e1, knight to g6, knight to f2, queen to e6, h4, queen to a6, h5, knight to f5, e5, knight to d5, f4, queen to a5, bishop takes d5, bishop takes d5, f5, c4, and now g5. All the Kasparov pawns are going through the king. So g5, h takes, bishop takes g5, king to h7, king to h2, knight to d7, bishop to f4, bishop to c6, rook to g1, rook to g8, knight to h3, rook a to f8, knight to g5 check, king to h8, and now h6, and black resigned, is completely lost. But in the game, d takes e3, but the opponent replied with queen to e7. And now, knight to h3. White immediately leads his knight along the itinerary h3, f4, d5. This is undoubtedly more accurate than e4, because after e4, queen to c5 check, king to h1, queen takes c4. When in comparison with the game continuation, black has gained an important tempo. So we play knight to h3, queen to c5, knight to f4, queen takes c4, e4, d6, and queen to d3. Worth considering is the positional pawn sacrifice with bishop to e3. Because after queen takes c3, we can play bishop to f2. Kasparov, with the idea of continuing the complicated struggle into the middle game. But queen to d3, knight to e5, later bishop to e6 and bishop to e3 was played here, and in this combative position a draw was agreed between Kalfmann and Grischuk 2002. But instead knight to e5, queen takes e4, knight takes e4, and now g4. The advance of the white pawns on the king side also proved effective into the endgame. One of its objectives is to prepare an invasion of the white knight on d5. Rook to b8. Preying the threat of g5, so g5, knight to d7, and now knight to d5. Rook d1, b6, g5, knight to d7, knight to d5, and rook to b7. After c6, knight to e3, black has problems with the defense of the d6 pawn. So instead, rook to b7. f4, knight to f8, rook to d4, knight to a5, f5, bishop to d7, rook to b1. White's space advantage can become threatening, but with his next move, black finds possibilities of counterplay on the queen side. c5, rook to d3, bishop to a4. And now the white pieces reply f4. White energetically fights for the initiative by sacrificing the exchange. He finally straightens out his pawn structure and will eliminate his opponent's important light squared bishop. Bishop to c2. Rook to b2, bishop takes d3, e takes d3, rook to d8, h4. The active knight on d5, tumenizing bishops and mobile pawns change on the king side provide full compensation for the sacrifice exchange. Knight to c6, black's immediate task is to drive away the knight on d5 from its dominating position. h5. Knight to e7, and now knight to e3. The white knight is transferred to g4 in order to support an offensive on the black king by means f5, f6, or h5, h6. Rook b to d7, knight to g4, and knight to c6. The black knight shadows its white counterplay. h6, knight to e5, bishop takes, pawn takes, h takes g7, king takes f7, bishop to f1. White wants to retain his knight on g4 for the attack, whereas it will be exchanged after knight takes e5. For example, knight takes e5, rook takes d3, knight takes, rook takes. His position looks threatening, but in mutual time, troubled black managed to defend. So he played bishop to f1, rook to d6, knight takes, f6, knight to g4, f takes g4 and g5, queen to h2, rook to h8, e5, rook to d5, f6 check, king to h8, knight to h6, rook d takes e5, knight to f7, and this is a draw. White doesn't have anything better to accept the perpetual check. So this was the second game of the book, How to Play the English Opening. I hope you enjoy it. Bye bye.